They'll be taking your calls. Gary Numan and Bill Sharpe with Change Your Mind.
This time it's your decision. We're into something new. I know that I'm sinking the way more can say. Time that I was thinking of no one else but me. Oh, we're changing minds. Nothing ever stays the same. Change your mind. No one ever plays a game. Change your mind. Give up what you can't defend. Oh, change your mind. Think you'll start again. Why can't you reconsider? Listen if you care. Take from me you give up. Reject me if you dare. Give me what I'm asking and save it all for me. Love that's never lost then is how it's meant to be. Why change your mind? Nothing ever stays the same. Change your mind. No one ever plays the game. Change your mind. Give up what you can't defend. Change your mind. Think it out and start again.
Sharpe and Gary Numan together. We're just adding up, chaps, how many hits you probably had each, probably about 10 or 12 each, something like that?
About a dozen.
Yeah, we're not doing too bad. We've got a few to catch up the Beatles, though.
Actually, people have asked me over the last few weeks why you got together. I know you're both down at Shepperton Studios, but how did the whole thing actually come about?
Well, Bill was doing his solo album at my studio, so I was around, obviously. And the engineer that he was using, I'd used in the past, and he was like the middleman, and mm-hmm. he suggested me for this song. And it all came about through him, really, sort of bringing the two of us together.
You liked the song immediately, did you? And thought,
oh, obviously, yeah. Yeah, as soon as I got the cassette of it, it was just a matter of when we could do it.
Great. And what do the rest of Shack Attack think about the idea?
Well, actually, they think it's quite a good idea, really, because it's... I mean, the way I'm doing it is is to help along the name of Shack Attack. I mean, right. There's no question of me leaving the band or anything. It's just
helping the name of Shack Attack. There's no question of leaving Shack Attack.
No, I'm not leaving the band. No, I'm not. But I mean, obviously, it keeps the name around because people know. I mean, they know the name of Shack Attack more than they know my name.
Yeah.
Whereas Gary is an established artist. I mean, right. I'm just a part of the band.
Great. So, well, I hope it all works out for you. If there is any future projects, think an album or anything.
It's possible.
Who knows?
Who knows? I think the last time I saw you, Gary, was down at Blackbush Airport, wasn't it? And I came in your plane.
Yeah, I've sold that now.
Have you?
Yeah, I've got a different one.
Great. What have you got now?
It's a Harvard. It's a World War II thing.
Yeah? Oh, great.
A bit scary. It's good fun, though, but it's a bit scary.
Right, well, maybe people want to chat about that. We've got the phones behind you. If you'd like to put yours up, we can chat to who? Hello? Keith D'Souza, hello?
Hello.
Oh, you're through to the lads.
Can I speak to you, Gary, please?
Hello.
What made you learn to fly an aeroplane?
The excitement of it, because it's very exciting. The challenge of it, because obviously it's very satisfying to be able to do it. And I suppose just the actual the feelings you get from it. It's like being on a fairground ride all the time. It's a lot of fun.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes, thank you.
That was easily answered, wasn't it? All right, thanks for your call. Bye-bye. Right, and we have Colette Argent.
Hello?
Hello, no relation to Rod Argent, are you?
No.
Oh, good. Okay, you're through to Bill and Gary.
Hello, Gary.
Hello.
And why did you decide to wear all the blue and white makeup in your videos all the time?
Because I haven't done it before, really. I had to think about what to do for a new image, because I got a little bit fed up with the other one. And I'd had lots of other colours, like reds and blacks and whites and all sorts of things, and I thought of blue. The idea came from a picture that I saw about 3 years ago, actually, of a woman that had been painted in all different colours. And the idea came from that.
Oh.
Just a different way of looking, that was all. Just something different.
Okay.
Okay.
Right.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Easily satisfied. Tricia Barker, hello.
Hello.
Good morning, Tricia. You're through to Bill and Gary.
Morning. Can I speak to Gary, please?
Hello.
Hello, Gary. Is it true about the articles and the sun? You need police protection?
No, not really.
No,
that I spoke to that man a few weeks ago, and we was talking about things that happened over the past, like the good and the bad side of being famous. And the good side's obvious, you know, there's money and things like that. But the bad side is obviously that you're a target for, cranks, I suppose, you know, it's odd people.
And there's nothing wrong at the moment, no?
No, I've had a few in the past, but nothing to take that seriously. But at the moment, there's no problem at all. And I did have a dog, but it wasn't ferocious, and it's gone back to me mum's now, anyway. So it kept missing on my floor.
Oh, that's all right, then.
So you're going to let your mum clean up?
Yeah. Suzanne, please.
Sorry?
Can you wave to my friend Suzanne, please?
Where is she?
In Liverpool.
There
Suzanne
she is.
Drive.
Hello, Suzanne.
Okay.
So I'm waving at the monitor.
Good luck at the single.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay
bye.
Then.
Bye bye.
Right, I'll make someone speak to you now, Bill.
No, I don't care.
No, I think
I don't care.
Nicola. Nicola. Have a chat with Bill. He's sitting on the end here like me and
hello?
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 Can you hear it?
What's your favourite hobby?
Bill, what's your
My favourite hobby? Actually I like fast cars. I've got a very fast car and I go way past the speed limit and I hope that the police aren't watching because I'll be driving down the M3 later at about 140. So
I can hear them sitting in the station now.
I won't really.
Mark these numbers.
No, but I do like fast cars actually.
It's a white Audi.
Yes.
Policeman.
Okay. Right. Thank you.
Thank
bye
you.
Bye. All right. Thanks very much for your call. Bye bye. Right. Well, that's all the calls you've got time for. But you have brought a bargain along, haven't you? All these goodies here.
Each actually, yeah. I've got this. This is a switch. This is mine, so it's actually got some blue dye on the collar. Sorry about that.
Never mind. Can't see that.
Test pressing of a single. That's
great.
Fine. This is what we get to make sure they're right before they're mass produced.
Probably worth a lot of money in years to come. A
couple of stickers from the aeroplane.
Great.
yeah. Bang about. What else have I got? Picture disc of a single some time ago. One of them.
Some Shack Attack hats.
Yes. And
hat attacks.
Other records and things, yeah.
Great load of records. And this. Actually, this little bus down the front's quite good, isn't it?
Yeah, that's from the video.
It looks good with a hat on, look.
Yeah. Also, we got this little live double album we did in Japan that you can't get over here.
Right.
So I thought somebody might be interested in that.
Great, okay, well, all these things, including his fabulous little sculpture that's in the video. We have a question. Do you want to do the question, or do you want me to do the question?
No, Bill's going to do the question.
Bill's going to do the question.
The question is, who is the artist who sculpted the thinker, you know, this one?
A clue.
Who did that?
All right. Who did the thinker? And the answer's on a postcard to Saturday Superstore, BBC Television, London, W12 8QT. Which artist sculpted the thinker? And you get the wonderful, wonderful bust here.
Not to be missed, top, really.
And not to be missed. Now all these wonderful bargains, which is terrific. Thanks a lot for bringing them in. Thank you. You're going to stick around and come on the pop panel a bit later, aren't you?
Thank you.
Fantastic. I think we might have time to take another couple more calls, actually, because people are phoning in here. So if you want to grab it, we have Pamela de Verger. Is that right?
Yeah,
that's right. Great. Okay, we've got time to squeeze you in. Good morning. You're through to Bill and Gary.
Yeah, hello. Could I speak to Gary, please?
Hello.
Yeah, I wanted to know, why did you continue with your image, although it was at first used intentionally to get a record contract?
Well, there's been lots of images, so I didn't continue with any one, really, and I didn't get an image to get a contract. I wrote some punk songs. I didn't have an image then. I got the image afterwards, and I started doing television. The whole reason to do punk songs was to get a contract, and that had nothing to do with the images at all, really. And I've had about, I suppose 7 since then, anyway. It's just, it's nice to keep changing the way you look, the same way as women change their hairstyles and clothes. We can't do that so easy, especially me, for various reasons. So I do other things. It's trying to keep the fans happy, really, trying to keep them interested in what you're doing. And if they wrote to me and said that they didn't like all the different images, then I would probably stop doing it and do something else, but they don't. Well, the majority of them don't, so I carry on doing it.
Do you like the new image here?
Oh yeah, it's wonderful.
Oh.
No, this isn't. This is casual, actually. It was too early to be bothered this morning.
Besides, the same for me every Saturday. People say, "What are you wearing that for?" I said, "I just got up and put something on." Stuart on the line. Hello, Stuart.
Hello.
Stuart Hunter. You're through to Bill and Gary.
Gary, where do you get the idea for your songs, and are you planning on doing a British tour?
Yeah, we hope to do another tour, late summer maybe. We're not sure exactly when yet, but certainly sometime this year. As far as the ideas for the songs is concerned, various things, really. Obviously, I had an accident in an aeroplane once. I got a lot out of that. Various things that happen, often people that you meet, even. Or sometimes quite silly things, like you're an advert on a television will have a catchphrase, and that can spark something off. It really can be any number of things.
What about you, Bill? How do you write yours?
I write with someone else, so I just write the music. I'm not a lyricist. I have a mental block with lyrics, and so really I don't sort of come into that problem.
Right.
But maybe one day I might write a song.
And maybe both of you touring together maybe this year? Or? Who knows? All these burning questions live.
Who knows what happens? Who knows what can happen?
All right. Okay, we'll look forward to that. Thanks for your call.
Thank you.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Right, thanks very much. Coming on the pop panel a bit later, have a look at someone else's videos. Meantime, you can slope off and have a cup of tea somewhere over in the coffee shop. Now it's time for a brief underwater excursion with David Attenborough.